Welcome back, National Gamers, and I'm here with Mafia 2, as today we're going to get started with this new Let's Play on this channel. Well, without further ado, let's go. The story. We're going to play on medium because we're not complete noobs, but we're not very good at this game because I've never played it. Alright. Cutscenes, here we come. Alright. Present. Mafia 2. Whoa, great. Okay. I'll just let the cutscenes roll on out.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, shit, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this
way! Brilliant.
Throw me to bed! Stop! I'll shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Back to Italy, chapter one. All right, the old country. All right.
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini's soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà. Eh?
No, no, eh? Per favore, no.
Sweet Jesus.
All right, Scaletta, take the shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate...
Let's move! On me!
Alright, let's go.
Get up and shit!
I'm down!
Come on!
Gesù! I'm going to get a prisoner for the
army.
Corporal?
Okay.
Machine gun nest, then find the prisoners. We're gonna need
Let's not die.
Hey, Scaletta, over here!
Space. That wasn't a very bright idea, but you know. Let's just not do that.
Can't get through this way.
Looks like we found the machine gun. Watch it.
You got a grenade, Scaletta. This would be a great fucking time to use it.
Alright, here goes. Ah, shit.
Scaletta, you alive? Yeah, just about. But then get off your ass and let's move.
Grab all the ammo you can carry. This might be our last chance. On the stairs!
Hey, Greaseball, catch!
Solo un graffio.
Fuck off.
Sei finito, idiota.
Fuck you.
Come out. Still want to get some ammo
first. Upstairs. Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
You want me to go die?
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Vaffanculo!
Bastard. Alright, who's next? Oh, fuck.
Got it.
Sort of need to heal first.
Door, Scaletta. Kick it in.
I don't want to. Not today, asshole. Oh, what the fuck? That's cool. Apparently you can shoot through doors that quickly.
Shit. Looks like we're going this way. Come on.
Okay. Bastard.
Shit! This balcony isn't gonna work! We gotta keep moving! Get inside! Get inside, Scaletta! You're gonna die out there! Let's go! Get on that machine gun! See that gun on the balcony, Scaletta? Get on it!
Die! God damn it. Get off! Get out of there!
sua.
Cosa state parlando?
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Davvero Don Calò?
Cacetto, un congè quando si amareta come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noi altri del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
Sweet. Well, that made things a lot easier because we aren't going to survive either way. Very lucky. And we're on chapter 2. Home sweet home. 2 years later.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
All right, digging this atmosphere.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal, what was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on, and you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit, Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here, wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
All right. That's great.
Salud.
Salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't wanna go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here. Hey, Giuseppe. It's Joe. Remember last week, you know... The guy's name is Vito Scaletti. Nice, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. The situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa, whoa. Did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
All right, we'll see, Joe. We'll see.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Did you just, like, instantly... Oh, okay, never mind. I'm stupid. I'm just gonna not say anything.
Here we are. All right, thanks. Keep the change.
Christmas.
And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Let's go to Oh Mother's and jaywalk. Finally kiss goodnight. How I'll hate going. Now it looks like we have a clothes store. But if you really hold me
tight, all the way home I'll be warm. I should go home. I haven't seen Mama and Francesca forever. First I'll go home. Then I go home.
Buddy. Okay, I guess you have to go this way. But as long as you love me. So you can go around at your own free will, but not as much as, like, I don't know, Grand Theft Auto. Which is fine. I don't know who you are. I'm going to see Mother. Typical ghetto as fuck neighborhood. To Mama's. Okay. Well, there's a cat. Not a very happy cat.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down, sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, pronunciata per la tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, provvedere per il cucino di Maria.
Okay.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
Sleep? Is this my room? Obviously, we share rooms. Close the door before going to bed. All right, buddy, fall asleep.
I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
Yes, I will, hopefully. The bed looks a little rickety, though.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
Well, let's go get dressed. We live in the ghettos, so we'll take this. Alright.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually,
Looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly. No. Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe.
Well, I can't guarantee anything.
Your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie, amigo.
All right, time to become a blue-collar man. All right. Not for very long, I imagine. Oh, goodbye, Mama. Let's go. Out the door. There we go.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll
if you
got
to sell everything
I promise.
You got. What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business, asshole.
No.
Oh, yeah?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
All right, let's punch this fucker.
Stop, please.
I'm getting owned. Fuck off.
Please, Vito, this isn't a problem.
Yes, it is. Apparently. Get gunned.
Ah, fuck this.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Good old Joe. He's only down the road. I wonder if we can just get over there. Gotta sprint to places sometimes, you know? I think we can actually steal cars, but I don't feel like doing that quite
what's
yet.
Up, man?
I'm in a rush. That's what's up. At the sky, of course. Alright. So I think those blue rectangles are police. And obviously that will become a problem that we'll have to deal with later on. Is this Joe's store? Very good one, if you ask me. Looks like he's up. Nice.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has...
That doesn't matter. We're here.
This is bad, huh?
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
Mr.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. Great. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers.
Giuseppe Pizzeria. All right.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me.
All right, let's go to the garage. You coming, Joe? You coming?
So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Fair enough. Let's go get some pizza.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You're gonna let me drive over?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while. Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Is there actual traffic laws in this game and you can't just go through red lights constantly?
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime, not functional.
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
All right, fair enough. What's in the street? Have to be head out there. I wish
I knew. You know, you wasn't kid. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Let's do you, Yui, because I already missed the fucking turn. And it's on top of that bridge, which is absolutely fantastic. You know what the horn is, man. The answer is why does Mr. Giuseppe have to be on top of the fucking bridge? Welcome has been lucky that you dropped in. So nice and warm. Look out the window. Alright, I think I'll end off the episode here at a very cringeworthy time, because I can't find where the bridge entrance is. I'd like to thank you for joining me on the episode, and I'll see you in the next one. Alright, peace out.